Most of the houses were built and owned by the Consolidation Coal Company, which was owned by and supplied the Chicago and Northwestern Railroad. The houses in the company town lacked plumbing and electricity, but they were spacious.
We had a living room, a dining room, and a kitchen with old wood stove. And then we had three bedrooms upstairs. And that's how we slept. Big, nice big yard.
And the houses were rented out to miners arriving from other communities without regard to race.
Houses were assigned on the order of the people who came in. So you might have an African American family, a white family, African American family. In other words, they didn't assign certain groups to certain parts of town. It was just that next house that was available.
Which meant much of Buxton was thoroughly integrated.
Blacks and whites lived next to each other. They weren't strangers, they were neighbors.
As the 1910 census shows, a few blocks like East 8th and 9th Streets were overwhelmingly black, but just down the block, the population was split almost equally between whites and blacks. Most of the whites were immigrant workers, primarily from Sweden, Slovakia, and the British Isles. Jason's grandmother, Geraldine, was born in Buxton in 1920. Her memories of the town are much fainter than those of her older sisters. She was only 4 or 5 when the family left town in the mid-1920s, but she does have at least one very vivid memory of her early childhood. It involves the white woman next door.
I remember going next door every afternoon, and this German lady, she would rock me every afternoon. I'll always remember that. I'll always remember her. That was something I look forward to every day.
One of your sisters was actually named after, I think it was one of your younger sisters.
Yes, her middle name is Wilmina. And I'm sure that's a German name.
Living side by side, black kids and white kids also went to school together. This was Aunt Catherine around 1920 with a white classmate. Both were taught by a black teacher, something also extremely unusual for the time.
My first grade teacher was named Mrs. Billingsley. She couldn't have been prejudiced against the whites, and the white teachers weren't prejudiced against the blacks. They treated us all as one.